गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास ऑफ रोटेशन. सॉरी, वेलकम बैक टू द क्लास ऑफ ग्रेविटेशन. द चैप्टर वी आर डिस्कसिंग, वी हैव डन टिल ग्रेविटेशनल पोटेंशियल. नाउ we have to go for gravitational potential energy, and then we will go to Kepler's laws. These are the two topics left in the first unit of gravitation. There are two units in gravitation. The first unit is regarding general information, general introduction and derivations, like various terms. That is, you are getting introduction to these terms, and then we will go to satellites, escape velocity, orbital velocity, etc. in the gravitation part 2. But before that, let us continue with gravitational field terms. So next is gravitational potential energy. So gravitational potential energy, just like gravitational potential, in gravitational potential you obtain the work obtained in bringing a unit mass from a given point within the gravitational field. Same is the case here, but here we have to bring a given mass. So gravitational potential energy is for given two masses. It is defined as work obtained or work done by the gravitational field of one mass. It is defined as work done by gravitational field, work done by gravitational field in bringing work done by gravitational field of a mass. Sorry. Work done by gravitational field of a mass in bringing another mass from infinity to a point within the field of first mass. So here it is for the system of mass to the position at a point within the field. So it is also defined under the gravitational field, but here the important part is you are taking another mass, not unit mass. So here unit mass will not be considered. It is gravitational potential energy for a system of masses. I am considering two masses. So it is defined as work done by gravitational field of a mass in bringing another mass from infinity to a point within the field. It is also a scalar quantity. It is also considered as negative. It is a scalar quantity. Scalar quantity means it has no direction. Now it has unit gravitational potential energy. Energy of any form will have the same dimension as that of work, and its unit will be joule. Now, expression for gravitational potential energy. So expression for gravitational potential energy for a given mass, let that mass be m. We have to find the potential energy at A. We have to bring another mass. Again, this is the same diagram which we have discussed in gravitational potential. This distance is r and this distance is x. But here there is no unit mass. We have to consider a mass m. So let the gravitational force acting on mass m be g m m upon x square at c. So for a small displacement dx, let the work done be dw, and dw is equals to, again we are finding work done for a small displacement, dw is equals to f dx. So dw f is equals to g m m upon x square dx. Now we have to find total work done in bringing given mass from infinity to point A, that is from infinity to R. So for total work done, which is the potential energy for total work from infinity to R, we have to integrate from infinity to R. Now this is 0 and this is W. Here you will get W, no problem. Now here GMM, integrate this, you are going to get x minus 1 upon minus 1 infinity to R, that is GMM. I am taking minus sign outside, 1 by x infinity to R. So work done here is equals to, which is gravitational potential energy, you can see G M M upon R. This is gravitational potential energy for any mass. This is gravitational potential energy for any mass. It is generally now denoted by capital U. So gravitational potential energy is denoted by capital U. From now on onwards, you will use capital U for gravitational potential energy. This is the expression for gravitational potential energy. Now, on the surface of Earth, if you are considering on the surface of Earth, so R becomes RE and M becomes ME. Let the another mass be of mass M. So here potential energy will be minus GME M upon RE. This is on the surface. This is on the surface. At a height h from the surface, it becomes minus GMEM upon RE plus h. This is with regard to Earth. if you want, you can take your loan. GME is equals to GRE square. So from 1, US becomes minus GRE square M upon RE. So this is minus M GRE. From 2, UH becomes minus GRE square M upon RE plus H. So this is at a height H from the surface. Now, as you know that gravitational potential energy is minus gm upon r, and gravitational potential energy is minus g mem upon r. So you can say that potential energy and potential are related as v into m. This is the relation which we will use in various numericals. So this you will use in various numericals. Now increase in potential energy in moving a body from surface of Earth to H height. So here on the surface you are having, you need to know what is the value of on the surface, minus g m e m upon r e, and at a height h, u h is equals to minus g m e m upon r e plus h. Now increase in potential energy. Delta u is equals to UH minus US. Solve for it. What is common? Minus GMEM, or you can write RE plus H, minus GMEM upon RE. So on solving this, you are going to get GMEM as common. What is left? RE plus H. Now solve this. On solving this, delta U is found to be MGH upon 1 plus H upon RE. Where G is GME upon RE square. So this is the increase in potential energy. If H is less than RE, then gravitational potential energy is MGH. If H is very very small compared to RE, then delta U is equals to MGH. So this is under a condition if H is less than RE. So this is all about gravitational potential energy. Gravitational potential energy is this much. Now next we will discuss about Kepler's laws.